Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. If you're coming here for the first time, I'm a mentor for RBI, SEBI, NABARD and UGC NET examinations. Today, I'm going to be talking about the book list for RBI Grade B examination. If you are not aware about RBI Grade B, there are a total of three levels or phases of this examination. Phase 1, Phase 2 and Phase 3. Phase 1 has only one paper which comprises of four topics. Phase 2 has a total of three papers. And phase 3 is the interview phase, जहाँ पे आपके साथ interview होता है. So let's start with phase 1. But before starting, let me give you a warning that if you are going to prepare on your own for any government examination, let alone RBI, तो गधे की तरह सब कुछ पढ़ने की कोशिश ना करें. You have to try and act like a horse. Be smart, try to work like a horse, try to run around. Only in the important areas. तो अगर आप एक book उठा रहे हैं, if I'm telling you the name of a book, you don't have to finish it cover to cover. You have to cover only the important portions from that book. Now that is an art and a skill which you will understand with time. First day mein to nahi aayegi aapko. It will take some time, but with consistency, you will be able to understand what's important and what's not important. So let us start with the phase one. Now, as I said, phase 1 is one paper which is made up of a total of four topics. ये चार topics क्या क्या हैं? We have quant, we have reasoning, we have English, and then we have general awareness. Quant, reasoning और English, इन तीनों को, all these three can be divided into two further parts. What are these two parts? The conceptual part and the practicing part. Conceptual part मतलब understanding topics like HCF, LCM, averages, prime numbers, time, speed, distance, the conceptual understanding of these topics. And what is the practicing part? Making sure that you are able to solve all kinds of questions from all these topics. For example, if you pick up time, speed, distance, then there might be five different types of questions that can be asked from time, speed, distance. So understanding how to solve all these five types of questions and solving them on pen and paper, using pen and paper, is the practicing part. अगर हम कॉन्सेप्ट की बात करें, यूजिंग द बुक्स इज अ वेरी ओल्ड स्कूल मेथड विच शुड नॉट बी यूज्ड एनीमोर. वो मेथड पुराना हो चुका है. यू हैव टू ग्रो विद टाइम, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द रियलिटी ऑफ द टाइम. अभी रियलिटी क्या है? द रियलिटी इज दैट यू हैव टू यूज वीडियोज. यू शुड बी यूजिंग वीडियोज इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट्स बेटर एंड फास्टर. आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है? टाइम सेव करना, जल्दी से जल्दी सब कुछ कवर करना. सो वीडियोज आर अ बेटर वे ऑफ डूइंग दैट. You can follow n number of videos which are available on YouTube with respect to quant, reasoning and English. In teenon ke liye aapko bahut achhi achhi videos, bahut achhe achhe channels mil jayenge usually. You can use them. The second part is the practicing part. Practice ke liye aap bahut sari books available hai. You can use any of those books. Let me name you some of the books. Banking Services Chronicle has their own practice question booklets for banking exams. Then you have Kiran's publications with practice questions. I also publish book on RBI Grade B examination with practice questions for quant, reasoning and English. And then you have books like CL Career Launcher and Time for CAT, which can be useful to some extent as well. So these are the books that you have to use to practice the concepts that you've already understood. Okay, I hope that it's clear. Now let's come to general awareness part. General awareness can also be divided into two major portions. The current affairs part and the static GK part. Current affairs ke liye Spotlight is the best magazine if you are preparing for RBI, SEBI or NABARD. In teenon mein se kisi bhi exam ki aap taiyari kar rahe hain, then Spotlight is the best magazine for covering current affairs. The second part is the static GK part. You can go to any website. There are a lot of websites, for example, GK Today and Affairs Cloud. These two are good ones. A lot of students rely on these websites. You can go to these websites for the static GK part. They're available for free or for a very minimal fee on these websites. On my website, Static GK is not available for free because it is only meant for enrolled students. Now, one more thing that I want to clarify here is, what is the difference between Spotlight and Static GK or Affairs Cloud? In teenon mein difference kya hai? Please understand that for current affairs of phase 1, GK Today or Affairs Cloud, whatever content they are providing, it is meant for all government examinations, whether it is RBI, SEBI, NABARD, SBIPO, IBPSPO, RRBs, Railways, SSCCG, all these examinations, whatever current affairs is provided is covered by GK Today and Affairs Cloud in one go. On the other hand, Spotlight is focused only on RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination, and that's why it's recommended over these other platforms specifically for daily current affairs only. Okay. Now, having understood the phase one, let's jump to phase two. Phase two, as I said, can be divided into three major portions. You have economic and social issues, you have finance and management, and then you have English descriptive. Economic and social issues. What are the books? The first one is NCERTs, of course. There is macroeconomics NCERT of class 12th, and then there is Indian economic development of class 12th. These two NCERTs are very good, are in fact the best ones if you want to cover ESI from the very basics. Upon these basic books, you can build up your understanding of ESI by using Indian Economy by Ramesh Singh, which is meant for UPSC but is equally useful for RBI, SEBI and NABARD as well. Okay, SEBI ke liye it is not useful anymore because the portion of ESI has been removed from SEBI. So SEBI ke liye hata dete hain. So for RBI and NABARD, for ESI syllabus portion, we have Indian Economy by Ramesh Singh, and then we have NCERTs, Indian Economic Development and Macroeconomics. Now, please remember that 70% of ESI paper is made up of current affairs and 30% is made up of the syllabus portion. However, in order to understand the current affairs, which is 70%, you need to have a good understanding of the syllabus also. Otherwise, this current affairs is going to be half-baked. आपको अच्छे से समझ नहीं आएगा. तो आपको ये syllabus portion cover करना जरूरी है, for which the books that I've recommended, please go through them very thoroughly. The next portion in ESI is, as I said, the current affairs part, which includes government schemes, which includes indices and reports, which includes international organizations, which includes PIB and newspapers like Hindu. It becomes all too confusing and convoluted. So, isko hum parts mein divide karte hain. There are topic-wise coverages. For example, government scheme is one topic. Indices and reports is one topic. And then there are current affairs which are spread out. जैसे आपने रूम में सब कुछ फैला दिया, it's like that. In order to cover the ESI current affairs part, the spread out part, you can refer to PIB 247, which is covered by Manish sir on my channel on a daily basis. Daily वो आते हैं, daily वो cover करते हैं, and it's covered in a beautiful manner through questions. So you can easily refer to PIB 247 if you want to cover the spread out part of current affairs related to ESI. If you want to cover the topic-wise part, government scheme, indices and reports, etc., etc., you can either refer to UPSC material, agar aap self-study kar rahe hain, and if you've already taken the course, you know that it's already provided in a very well-organized manner in the course itself. Okay. Now, having done the ESI, let's come to finance and management. Finance and management can be divided in a total of three parts. Finance theory, finance numerical, and management. These are the three parts. Let's start with finance theory. Finance theory can be covered through two major sources. The first source is RBI FAQs. RBI ki website pe aapko FAQs milenge, frequently asked questions, which are generic topics like mutual funds, collective investment schemes, NBFCs, MSMEs, n number of basic topics which are related to RBI are being covered there. To aapka first objective hone wala hai RBI FAQs ko cover karna. The second thing that you're going to cover in finance theory is a book by Bharti V. Pathak called as Indian Financial Management, Indian Financial System. Is book ko aap cover karenge, again, not cover to cover because there are a lot of provisions, lot of rules and regulations related to Indian financial system which are provided in this book. And you have to understand ki RBI examination mein kabhi bhi rules, regulations, provisions nahi aate hain. They always go back to the concepts. Concepts, terms, facts. These are the three important parts. हमने फाइनेंस थ्योरी कवर कर लिया थ्रू दिस बुक बाय भारती वी पाठक कॉल इंडियन फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज आरबीआई एफएक्यूज. देन कम्स दी करेंट अफेयर्स पार्ट ऑफ आरबीआई. इट इज कवर्ड ऑन अ डेली बेसिस अगेन बाय मानसी मैम एट 9 AM थ्रू अ सीरीज कॉल्ड एज आरबीआई 247. उसमें हम क्या करते हैं, वी पिकअप आरबीआई वेबसाइट, वी पिकअप सेबी वेबसाइट एंड वी पिकअप लाइव मिंट न्यूज़पेपर. इन तीनों को कंपाइल करते हैं एंड देन वी क्रिएट अ वीडियो through questions on a regular basis for you guys. So you can easily refer to that video, they are available on YouTube. Usse aapko samajh aa jayega what kind of questions are asked in finance theory current affairs. Okay. Now the finance numerical part, which is the least important in your preparation, because यहाँ से पिछले दो साल से questions नहीं आए हैं, but they can again start asking questions from finance numerical portion. Which is the book that you need to cover? Prasanna Chandra, called as Theory and Practice, FM Theory and Practice. So now we have understood how to cover ESI, how to cover finance theory, how to cover finance numerical, how to cover finance current affairs. The last portion of finance and management, and in fact the most important portion, is the management part. If we divide and break out the entire finance and management paper, we will see that management holds an importance about 50%. 50% of the paper comes from management. 30% of the paper comes from finance theory, and about 20% comes from finance current affairs. So 20% finance current affairs, 30% ho gaya finance theory syllabus, and about 50% comes from management. Management can be divided into two major parts. Do parts mein divide kar sakte hain. The first part is human resource management, and the second part is principles of management. Human resource management, principles of management. Both these parts can be covered very well by books by T.N. Chhabra. T.N. Chhabra's book on human resource management and his book on principles of management, both of them are available on Amazon. I have checked them personally. So you can easily purchase these books and cover them. Although these books are a little difficult to understand because they are authored by Indians, but at the same time, although they are technical, but at the same time, they cover majority of the things that can be asked in the examination and that are asked in the examination. Okay, so this is about covering the entire phase two. The third paper in phase two is English descriptive, which I'm going to cover separately, because English descriptive is not about covering through books. It can be covered well only by writing. So aapko regularly likhna padega if you want to score well in English, and I'm going to teach you how to write well. What is the process that you follow in order to write well if you want to score well in your English paper in phase two of this examination. So I hope this book list of RBI examination is going to help you prepare well on your own if you are thinking about preparing for RBI. And the thing that is stopping you from starting your preparation is lack of books or lack of understanding as to how do you start your preparation. All the very best, guys. Take care.